I'm going to start with a story about why it's inevitable that I'm here today. In 1985, I was a somewhat shiftless high school student, and my mom was all over me to get involved in speech and debate. And I wanted to pick something that I was deeply interested in to write a speech and to compete in these tournaments. I decided that was actually a good idea. And what I chose was sports fan violence. I chose the some of the things that had happened in the Premier League and hooliganism, and I thought that it would be interesting to think about American stadiums and how we made them safer, setting me on the path to today, where I get a chance to come and discuss this yet again. Over the intervening years, have spent a lot of time both thinking more recently, as we took control of the Kings 2 years ago and began constructing our new stadium, and as I began my service on the Super Bowl 50 committee as well for Levi's Stadium, about how we, how we approach these things. Although I should stress, I'm speaking for myself today and not necessarily for either my partners in the Kings or the other committee members. But we, we were thinking about those in physical space. But I also want to talk to you about digital space and how important that can be in all of these as we set the tone for the afternoon of discussions. Obviously, in the digital space, there's a lot to be said about the morning topics around corruption, around the challenges that are had. But this rise of transparency and the recording of all of these things that are going on, the ease of which social media allows access to that information, means that corruption can be fought more effectively, and that is indeed a wonderful thing. But it also means that physical threats to sports environments can be enhanced by, and if the response to physical threats can be enhanced by wise use and attention to digital technology. Fundamentally, this all comes down to architecture. You can think about it in two sides of the same coin, that there's the physical architecture that we're talking about, venues, access, how all these different aspects are set up and how they're determined. But then there's also a major digital play about credentialing, about who gets access. And now that everyone is holding a supercomputer in their hands, there are new things that can be done around around those approaches. But I don't just want to think about venue access questions as digital questions. I also want you to think about the way that attention to sports events gets formed in the digital environment, the way that people are using Facebook posts and tweets and Tumblr posts and everything else to establish their reactions over time, both those who are fans of the event and of the teams and of the participating in the social network. My partner in the Kings, Vivek Ranadive, likes to say, sports teams are social networks at the end of the day, and I think that's absolutely true. But also, when we think about threats to these events, there are social networks around that too, that people are seeking attention because so much other attention is directed at those events. And so the monitoring and activity on networks around posting, around recruitment, around identification of where threats might come from can also have a deep digital aspect to it. So we need to think about three big ideas when we're thinking about securing venues for events. One is people, both the people who might accidentally cause problems through stampedes and other things like that. The spaces themselves, how amenable they are to both access control, safety, and the way that those things are thought through. And then these threats and where they may come from. So we have to identify the people who are part of this, including the fans, define the proper access to this to these spaces, and then identify these threats. In the two projects that I've been focused on of late, we're looking at a variety of options. For the King Stadium, we're having a perimeter plaza that can also be access controlled in the right environments. And as the Kings begin their long winning streak again tonight, after a couple of challenged games against the Clippers, one of the best teams in the NBA, the move toward sort of having more and more people in this new venue that we're designing, we're going to have a variety of access control points on the plaza and then in the arena. And we've designed a very modern arena that opens up to the outdoors, But a lot of the access control points are going to be sitting outside the perimeter of the event. And obviously, you know, Super Bowl 50, as it comes up, you know, historically around large events that I've, you know, had the pleasure of taking part in and watching for years, everything from political conventions to the Super Bowl, you know, a couple of years ago, where I still, you know, want to make a commentary and wonder if somebody made Governor Christie upset in dealing with the Secaucus train station and getting to Super Bowl 48, but that's neither here nor there today. But the you know, figuring out how that access control works and how you get flow through. And so, you know, ideas that are being looked at for Super Bowl 50 include staggering access times and getting only, you know, a certain amount of throughput through at a given time. Thinking about these architectural issues is a critical part of what we think about in physical space. But also the information that gets that, you know, that message to people. Thinking about how the communication environment is going to work digitally, how you're going to make sure to get, you know, important information to people's smartphones, so that if God forbid there is a serious incident, that you know, the departure can be orderly, but to avoid incidents like, you know, the jamming of trains, et cetera, the jamming of access points, by providing better information. Over time, that merge of the physical and the digital, thinking about security as a process, is the critical way to approach all of these things. So all in all, I'm thrilled to be here and to set this tone for the afternoon session. I do believe it wasn't just Juliet Kayyem's introduction, you know, and thought of me for this that led me here. But I want to, you know, say a special thanks to my mother for pushing me to get involved in thinking about sports fan violence long ago.